Iberá was a place that was degraded by humans, and it's a place that is being recovered by humans. This is an incredible example of what we can achieve if we have the decision of restoring an ecosystem in a large scale. My job is related mostly to bring back the species that went extinct in these different national parks in which we are working. The biggest project is based here in Iberá. A big project sometimes is so complicated that you cannot do it by yourself. In Rewilding Argentina, we develop a team that is an incredible group of people. They are passionate for their work. The very first species that we reintroduced here in Iberá was the giant anteater. Every animal that we release has a transmitter. That way we can follow the animal after it's been released. So the guys that monitor them can look at them several times a week and see how they are adapting to the new environment.
Okay. Merci. 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 Vení, merci.
Bueno, está súper dormida, sí. Pero está perfecta, ¿no?
Está, sí, no. Sí.
Bueno, no, la dejamos acá tranquila y, sí. Y listo. Ya lo que queríamos ver lo vimos.
Así que está,
bueno,
entonces.
Un espectáculo, Pablo.
Muy bien.
Dale, vamos.
Listo, vamos.
They are doing incredibly well by their own. So the anteater is a story of success, really. We are in the northeastern part of Argentina, in a province called Corrientes, in the Iberá National Park. It's one of the biggest wetlands of South America. It's a very productive ecosystem. It's full of mammals and birds and reptiles, and also a lot of species that went extinct in the last century. There were a lot of hunters inside the marsh. They started to hunt birds to get the feathers, and they then turned to other species like caimans, capybaras, jaguars to get their skins. Our vision is to try to help reverse the biodiversity extinction crisis that we are facing. How we do that in Argentina is by protecting what is left. That's why we create big national parks like Iberá. And we restore the land mostly by reintroducing keystone species that went extinct that are crucial for the ecosystem functioning. We are working in different places in Iberá. So far there are 6 different places where we are reintroducing species. And then we develop economic activity for the local people so they can get benefits from that park that is going to be created and the wildlife that we are starting to recover. Some of the species that now are very common, those ones they could recover, but others could never recover by themselves. For us to start the project, we have to bring animals from captivity.
So now we are heading to one of the quarantines that we have for the project. In this quarantine, we also have a giant anteater rescue center. Every year, several animals arrive to the center. Most of them are orphans whose mother had been killed by poachers.
All the animals that come from captivity start their journey in the project in the quarantine.
Ali.
¿Todo
bárbaro? Bueno, entramos.
Ali is an Argentinian biologist, and she's the one that takes care of all these animals until they are ready to go to the field to be released. Okay. Usually when the animals arrive, they are very small. They need to be fed with special milk several times a day.
Todo cosas fuimos aprendiendo, ¿eh? Al principio,
claro,
algunos.
Claro, sí.
La época de Javi, Marcela, eso, los primeros ositos, muchos se murieron por aspirar leche.
Ah, sí.
O sea, no muchos, pero un par, así chiquitos.
Claro.
Sí.
Okay.
When they are big enough to carry a harness with a transmitter, we can release them in the wild. The giant otter is another species that went completely extinct in Argentina because of hunting, because we destroyed their habitats through logging. It's the first time that a reintroduction project is run for giant otters. But the thing is that there are no otters in captivity in Argentina. So Coco is the first male of the project. He's still in the quarantine. He came from a zoo in Denmark. And once he finished the quarantine, we will bring them to the Ibera Park, to a pre-release pen, where a female that also came from Europe is waiting for him. That's Alondra. Coco and Alondra, they don't know each other, so there's a long way for them to learn how to raise the cubs. And once they are ready, we will be able to release them in the wild. With the macaws, we have the most hard work for rehabilitating those animals, because most of the macaws that we bring to the project, they come from zoos or wildlife rescue center, where they spend many years of their lives in small cages without the possibility of flying. You not only have to change their diet, but we also have to teach them how to fly. It can be up to 1-2 years for each individual, in which we train these animals that come from captivity to survive in the wild. All this park creation process and rewilding process cannot be done without the support of the local communities.
Hola, Leiva, ¿cómo estás?
Pellegrini is a small town by the Ibera Park that had an economy that was based mostly in forestry, cattle ranching, and rice field. Now, since the creation of the provincial reserve, their main economic activity is ecotourism.
Nos hemos criado con toda esta cultura y el local está orgulloso de poder mostrarlo. Ya que en torno al parque hay muchas historias de vidas que han cambiado. Un pueblo entero empezó un proceso de cambio encontrando respeto por su naturaleza.
People become proud of what they have. And now young people choose to stay in their hometown. And they start to run ecotourism business as local guides. They use their knowledge and they become very proud that people come from different parts of the world to see what they know.
Hoy vive en el paraje de Iberá. Hoy están orgullosos porque pueden quedarse en su lugar de origen sin salir de donde vivieron toda su vida. Le permite tener un ingreso que le permita vivir a las familias que todavía están adentro.
Thirty or 40 years ago, we had the idea that the best thing that you can do to preserve a species is not touch anything. Now we say that the best thing that you can do, and sometimes the only thing that you can do, is to be very active.
Dijo que Mario andaba más o menos por el perímetro, tipo por allá.
So far, we've been successful reintroducing some of the species here, like the giant anteater, the pampas deer. But we are just starting with the top predators, like the jaguar. So there's a lot of work to do here.
Maga, maga, me copias.
Te copio.
¿Qué onda? ¿Hay alguno por ahí cerca o estamos todo tranqui?
Marihuana en el perímetro de atrás y ya Tomasinho no lo veo.
The jaguar reintroduction project is the most complicated and ambitious project that we have. We built a very big reintroduction center with very huge pens. If you go there, it looks like a Jurassic Park for jaguars. So far, we already have 5 animals at this reintroduction center that we think are ready to be released. We hope that during this year, we will have the first jaguars living free in Iberá, and that will be like the coronation of the rewilding project because it has never been done before.
We have to move one of the female jaguars, Marihuá, to the biggest enclosure of the reintroduction center. It's a very big step for the project because it's almost free of our management. So it's like being already living free.
Y ver todo esto hoy es más allá de la infraestructura que se ve, está a la vista, que es magnífica. Ver el avance de los proyectos emociona un poco.
Sí, ¿no?
El proyecto Yaguareté es algo insólito, digo, es algo único. Hay algo espiritual dando vueltas, hay una magia que está dando vueltas en torno a este proyecto en las comunidades. Hoy es un, nada, cargado de emoción, de alegría, de incertidumbre, de cómo nos va a ir. Entonces, feliz y orgulloso este día.
Rewilding is not only about bringing back the keystone species that went extinct. Rewilding is a proactive conservation action that brings joy to your soul. When I see a group of macaws flying, what you see is all the effort that you put so that these birds can make it. It's many months of work with any individual, so it's not just two macaws flying, but also a lot of history behind those incredible colors. We don't live in cities. We live in the place where we are working. We become neighbors of the local people. They are the ones that can tell you the stories about the animals, about the places. As a team, we are really proud that we are developing a good example that we don't need to destroy nature to have a better life quality. You just feel a great satisfaction that we are fixing, as a species, most of the bad things that we did in the past. I always think is, if we can reintroduce jaguars in a place that they went extinct, what else we cannot do? I think we it's like we can do everything.
Soy Ibera Laguna, horquilla soy paso claro, Galarza cruzó a la luna, cerequita de la disparo, Laguna, Tigre y Valle, Camarreta soy estero, San Marcos y Guayaibu, soy Abañel Loreto, soy Isla Antonio María, Carambo bajo el cielo, Paguero en Yajaveré, Ñupe, Arroyo Plumero, Paraná y Misteriosa, Gallosa, Puca y adentro, en mi tatu me hago río.